Hey guys, before we begin, I want to let you know that this episode is sponsored by CuriosityStream, a subscription streaming service that offers thousands of documentaries and non-fiction titles from some of the world's best filmmakers, including exclusive originals. There's such an incredible amount of content on here, it's amazing. Scanning the pyramids, the history of food, so many good ones. Get unlimited access starting at $2.99 a month, and just for you guys, my audience, the first 30 days are completely free if you sign up at curiositystream.com/Matt Santoro and use the promo code Matt Santoro during the sign up process. Not only will you get 31 days free from CuriosityStream, but from now until January 5th, if you sign up for an annual plan, you get 40% off. That means that you get a whole year of CuriosityStream for $11.99. Gift cards are also 40% off so that you can give the gift of curiosity. So go to the link in the description, curiositystream.com/Matt Santoro now and use my promo code Matt Santoro during sign up. Thanks again to CuriosityStream for sponsoring this video. Now, here we go. Time to mix in some happy videos again. Yes, we're back. If we can just focus. Okay, there we go. The universe is a strange place filled with intrigue and wonder. Throughout human history, we've developed theories about how our universe works based on the available evidence at the time. This led to religion, philosophy, and eventually science. But as science has explored the universe at a subatomic quantum level, the real truth underpinning all of reality has revealed itself to be stranger than any fiction. Here are 10 quantum physics facts to blow your mind. Number 10 is entanglement. Entanglement is easily one of the most bizarre parts of quantum physics. When two particles come into contact with each other, they create an entangled relationship. Now imagine you keep one particle, let's call it Tom. Then you send the other particle, we'll call it Jerry, to a scientist living thousands of miles away. You would imagine that the particles would now have no relationship because they are so far apart, but you'd be wrong. If you change the direction that Tom is spinning in, Jerry, thousands of miles away, will start spinning in the exact opposite direction instantaneously. It's not fully understood how this is possible, but we now know for a fact that this spooky behavior is real because in July of 2019, scientists finally photographed entangled particles for the first time. Suddenly, I'm in the mood to watch Tom and Jerry cartoons. Excuse me. Number 9 is physical duality. Our natural experience of the world is that things have a definitive singular state. A cheeseburger is a cheeseburger, and that's fantastic because they're so tasty. You'd be shocked if you were about to eat a burger and it suddenly turned into broccoli, which, ugh. Worse still, what if the cheeseburger was actually both a cheeseburger and broccoli at the same time? Thankfully, our experience of the world does not work like this. However, at a quantum level, subatomic particles like electrons appear to have what is known as wave-particle duality. Many physicists believe that particles are both physical points in space and, at the very same time, have wave-like properties. But how can an electron be both a particle and a wave at the same time? What's even more mind-bending is that some physicists believe even large objects, such as human beings, are waves as well. Well, yeah, if you dance right. Oh boy. Number 8 is consciousness creates the universe. Now this one is controversial and it has been debated for 100 years, but nonetheless, it's a fascinating theory which still has the support of famous physicists such as Henry Stapp. This theory argues that consciousness is essential to the universe. Not only that, but that consciousness in some way creates the universe around us. Thinking back to the idea of things being both particles and waves at the same time, many believe that the reason we experience the world as solid objects is because the wave has to collapse into a solid point when it's measured. Henry Stapp believes that our minds are what causes this collapse when we look at things. The bizarre consequence of this is that when we are not looking at something, it doesn't really exist in any solid state. This is true, it is our minds which bring reality into being. You're literally creating me right now. Number 7 is time doesn't exist. In his book, The Order of Time, theoretical physicist Carlo Rovelli makes the shocking claim that time itself does not exist. He believes that at a quantum level, the universe can be understood without even thinking about time. Rovelli points out that while we see the world changing in front of our eyes because time flows forward, quantum mechanics shows that this is nothing more than an illusion. Our brains have evolved to understand the universe and experience it in a certain way. At a quantum level, things happen, but not in any linear way. Cause and effect break down, according to Rovelli, because they don't actually exist in the way we have normally thought. He argues that the universe is chaotic, and that we only order this information in order to make sense of the universe, when essentially, the universe is a collection of random happening events. See, I can get down with that one. I agree, because my entire life is just full of all kinds of weird random events. Like that. Number six are hidden variables. In our day-to-day lives, if we cannot understand something, we tend to think that we are missing something. If you try to fix a car engine, for example, and can't figure out why it isn't working, it's probably because you don't currently possess the knowledge required to fix it. In quantum physics, a similar concept is known as the hidden variable theory. This means that quantum physics appears so bizarre to us and so different from our daily experiences that we must be missing variables which would explain it and make it all understandable. However, some physicists believe that hidden variables, by their very nature, are undetectable. This means that we will never be able to understand reality no matter how hard we try. From this perspective, the universe will always be mysterious, which I'm okay with because I love a good mystery. Arf. Number five is the many worlds hypothesis. Quantum physics is very strange, what with ideas like consciousness collapsing waves into single points and making reality. As it turns out, a lot of physicists agree, and that's why many believe they've solved this weirdness with their own theory, the many worlds interpretation. But as with all things quantum, even the solution to quantum weirdness has mind-blowing consequences. Theories suggest that every single possibility plays out at a quantum level. Your subjective experience is of a world where the wave function collapsed into one state, but there are potentially an infinite number of other yous experiencing different states. That means that there's a version of you who is a famous actor, and another version of you who is in jail for something, stealing something. You bad boy. Each moment, you split into more and more versions of yourself. Now, that's an identity crisis. Number four is quantum immortality. Staying with the many worlds interpretation of quantum physics for a moment, another strange consequence is the possibility of living forever. In fact, Hugh Everett, who created the many worlds interpretation, believed that the existence of many worlds guaranteed him immortality. Everett theorized that if every possibility plays out, that there would be worlds where the conscious observer dies and ones where they live. In fact, Everett believed that the conscious observer could never truly die and would always exist in one of those worlds. Others around that person might experience them dying in their world, but the person's consciousness would simply split off into another existence where they managed to escape death. Now, I know these theories are still debated, but personally, I really like it because it's a lot closer to Rick and Morty, which is a fantastic show. If you have not seen it, they talk about stuff like this. So good. Number three is future Big Bangs. Cosmology tells us that the ultimate fate of the universe may be a very dark one indeed, but quantum physics may provide a way out of this depressing end. You see, a popular theory in cosmology is that all the matter in the universe will eventually unwind until there is no stars, planets, or fast food outlets. I kid, fast food will always exist. But seriously, that's what's called the Big Freeze, where the universe will go dark and essentially be so cold that nothing can really happen there anymore. However, some quantum physicists believe that in this event, over trillions and trillions of years, a phenomenon called quantum tunneling would eventually spontaneously create a new Big Bang. From the ultimate death of the universe would come a brand new universe, populated by stars, planets, people, and, yes, again, fast food outlets. Number two is quantum biology. Biologists have always tried to understand life at a macroscopic level, but a new field known as quantum biology is adding its own mind-blowing insights to the animal kingdom. Quantum biologists believe that natural selection has led some organisms, if not all, to use quantum effects in some way. For example, the way plants turn photons of light into energy seems to require that plant biology uses quantum events to make this possible. Others theorize that the way that birds navigate using electromagnetic fields may also require biology to process quantum information. But most striking of all are theories of the mind, which speculate that quantum events are not just used by the human brain, but may actually be consciousness itself, operating at a deep level within matter. If there's never been a superhero called the Quantum Man, sign me up, Marvel! I'm looking at you. You need new content. Your characters are dying, and I could be the first bald superhero, right? I think there's no bald superheroes. Anyway, sign me up. And number one is something from nothing. When we think of the distance between objects and space, we usually have the impression of a dark void. Space is a vacuum. There's no air, and therefore there's nothing in space. However, quantum physicists are showing that this idea is incorrect. Space contains things called virtual particles, which usually appear in pairs and then instantaneously cancel each other out. These particles appear to spontaneously arise, which is akin to something coming from nothing. It almost seems like a miracle, but where it gets really bizarre is that physicists like Lawrence Krauss believe that empty space can even generate the fabric of space and time from this void. This may be how our universe began in the first place. In fact, everything that's around you came from nothing. We are literally nothing. Except for you guys. You're everything to me. You special. But as always, thank you so much for watching and for subscribing to my channel. And a very special thank you to all of my channel members, especially the names you see on your screen right now. All of you help keep my channel going. Thanks again. Happy videos are back. We gotta mix it up with the creepy ones. And I will see you guys next time.